So our second speaker, Professor Tom Peters, is a lecturer and researcher at the AP University of Applied Sciences and Arts in Antwerp, Belgium. He has a master's in electronics and ICT engineering and is teaching software and web development courses. Tom is currently the international coordinator for electronics ICT program in the science and technology department and Excellus Erasmus Plus partner of HIT, joining effort in mutual projects and educational development through VR and other technologies. His journey through research project Show and Tell is amazing.
Tom Peters, my friend, hi. Well, I invite you please to start your talk.
Okay, thank you, Nava. Okay, all right, thank you very much. Hi, my name is Tom Peters. I'm a researcher and lecturer from the UP University of Applied Sciences. It's in Belgium, it's in Antwerp. And the movie clip you just saw represent actually my talk of today. The world is getting smaller, the world is getting more complex, and there is more diversity and technology. Students need to be taught 21st century skills in order to deal with innovation. How can we deal with new technology challenges? How do we teach them 21st century skills like collaboration, critical thinking, innovations, communication? Well, by defining a challenge in a new and unknown domain for students, such as immersive storytelling in virtual reality, they need to tackle the horseless carriage syndrome. And we use the grid as an instrument to enhance the ability to think out of the box. Maybe you can show my presentation again. Thank you very much. So, what is that horseless carriage syndrome? Well, what you see in this slide is actually the first car. It looks like a horseless carriage. So, actually, every new technology was first looked at with eyes that were used to technology we already knew. We make use of state-of-the-art technologies such as virtual reality, which has not yet revealed all of its possibilities. So students have to be creative and try to innovate, because in the creation of virtual reality experiences, no one has defined any rules yet. So I'm talking about virtual reality. What is virtual reality? Well, virtual reality is a user experience where the user is involved in a responsive virtual world. So it's totally new. It's a responsive world. So a virtual world is surrounded. You have 360 degrees of world, and you have to wear some hardware device, and it is responsive. The virtual world responds to the direction you are seeing. And it's totally new. It's totally different because we all knew cinema. And with cinema, there is a director and he gives you the image he sees through the lens and he gives you 20%. And the other 80% you have to figure out yourself. That's the dialect of cinema. Here with virtual reality, we give you 360 degrees and you have full control. So the creators give you light, sound, atmosphere, but you, as the spectator, you act on your own. And currently, the breakthrough of immersive storytelling in virtual reality poses challenges on the production side, in the creation, and on the user side, because you have to wear goggles. And to reach immersion because immersion is very important. Storytellers need to investigate how they can embed technical innovations. So I'm talking about immersion. So we challenge students to teach them 21st century skills in a virtual reality challenge, and they need to immerse the spectator. I want to show you a short fragment about what immersion is. So this is what immersion is. Immersion is when a person forgets his position in space and time and believes he is in a different environment. And the fragment I just saw you is rather, it's calling moral questions here in this case. But students have to think how they can involve the user in their story. So the user has a loss of time, he is not being aware of other events taking place, he is not responding to the environment anymore. And research shows that users can be involved in varying degrees. And the challenge here is in the creation is the search for the Holy Grail, and that's total immersion. And to create this, we need a lot of expertises. So we need multidisciplinary teams in the creation of virtual reality immersive storytelling. And for that, we use the grid. The grid, what we call the grid, can be compared like a brain structure, which interconnects people with different backgrounds and know-how and used as an instrument to enhance the ability of interdisciplinary contributors to learn from each other and the environment to think out of the box. So to tackle the challenges, we connect a team with different expertises to the grid. And a multidisciplinary team of researchers and lecturers give them tools, give them a workflow. And this workflow, we created that workflow during a research project, show and tell. This workflow is giving us an efficient tool in the development of virtual reality experiences. I want to give you a student example. A multidisciplinary team of artists, designers, and IT engineers developed the Mondrian project. They were connected in the grid during a bachelor class. And students needed to immerse the spectator in an artist world. And the artist is Mondrian, and you see the work of Mondrian. Mondrian is he is famous for his contribution to abstract art through straight lines using primary colors, white and gray. And students, you see here, students make the painting alive. So a spectator is wearing goggles, and the moment he is wearing the goggles, he sees that the painting is living. I try to give you an idea how it looks like. So I'm going to show you a short movie clip, and you have to imagine that you are into the painting, and the painting is becoming alive. So, in this example, I was wearing the goggles and you saw actually what I was seeing during my experience. And you saw that the painting was getting alive. And We give the students a workflow and we give them tools to create these immersive experiences. So here in my slide, you see some working examples of students. So we do on creative storming. It's a brainstorming technique. From the brainstorming, we create concepts. And in the right upper corner, you see a cross, a kind of a cross. It's actually a quadrant, it's a top view of a 360 environment. And this way, students think on concepts, how they can tell a story in virtual reality. In the next phase of our workflow, students need to think on the specifications of the technical aspects. So we need IT engineers, we need artists, we need graphical designers, and the student teams need to figure out the role of the viewer, the role of the spectator, and think of the environment in a virtual world. They need to give answers on questions specific to parameters of a 360 immersive story. And these parameters relate to the position of the viewer, the atmosphere you want to create, the guidance of the viewer, etc. And here you see, actually in my slide, you see that IT engineers here, you see the development environment, are working together with actors, because the blue and red figure you saw in my virtual reality experience, these were real actors. It looks like it was computer-generated images, but there were real actors, and IT engineers worked together with artists to transfer the movements of the actors into the virtual reality environment, and the actors could interact with the primary colors, and that was making the painting alive in this environment. So, in our workflow of the creation of immersive stories, we need a kind of a management. We need to manage a cross-functional team. And actually, we are using a rugby-style approach. Our teams are self-regulating teams. This means that in rugby, the rule is there is no forward passing. It's not allowed. They have to pass from player to player. It's like in our management approach. Actually, we use Scrum. And like our team, they must organize themselves to pass work easily from one person to another person. And besides of the project management, we have our workflow in 5 steps. And we always use the principle of user-centered design thinking. So we're going from ideation, understanding the problem, to validation of the user, actually. And there is always a feedback. So this means user perception is crucial. We have to understand our user so that we could create immersive stories in virtual reality. So this process is very crucial in the creation of our immersive stories. I want to give you one extra example of student work. It's called the Empathy Machine. And it is an award-winning experience in Belgium, and it's used in expositions, and it's used during lectures. And the Empathy Machine is to create awareness in cyberbullying. And here, the grid connects people of graphical designers, animators, and actors, therapists, together to inform about bullying, about cyberbullying. And let me show you a little clip of it.
What the fuck are you still doing here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pimples today. I wonder how many there will be tomorrow.
Yeah. Don't kill yourself.
Nobody likes you. Go home.
Kill yourself.
Kill yourself. Kill yourself. Kill yourself. Fucking kill.
Okay, here you saw this. It doesn't have to be art that needs to be involved, but a lot of disciplines need to be involved in the creation of immersive stories. And here we combined real footage, real video clips to show emotions, and we combine it with animations, and we combine it with real actors. So you see the multidisciplinarity connected by the grid, and you see that it results in real work. So to conclude my talk, a multidisciplinary approach connecting expertises into the grid stimulates us to think out of the box. It encourages us to take bigger steps to uncover the potential of new technology. It allows us to think less about the technology itself, but more about the content, what we can do with the technology. So the grid is our tool to accelerate innovation. I want to thank you for listening. And if you have any questions, please ask. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor Peters. I'm still going on with that with the bereaved mother video.
That's, yeah, it's actually in this experience there are moral questions for it, because how far can you go? And that's what you can do with virtual reality. You can move persons to other places they cannot reach normally. And it's easy, you can put persons to the Mount Everest, and that's okay. But in this case, and that is what immersion is, and that's the power of virtual reality, that you can do a lot of things here, and you can immerse the spectator totally. And yeah, then other disciplines, other expertises have to think that there need to be philosophical questions, how far can we go?
Exactly. So actually, one of the participants has a question that refers directly to what you've just said. And the question is, where do we draw the border with immersion between the will to help people and the ethical issues that it raises?
Yeah, where do you put the border? We don't know yet, because it's a new technology. There are a lot of challenges in the creation. There are a lot of challenges on the production side, but there are a lot of challenges in the user side. And on the user side, is you have to wear goggles in it, but then there is also the race of moral questions. How far can you go? It's a kind of a discussion, and the multidisciplinarity here is very important, because if we only let it to technical people, only the technical things are involved. So we also have to address philosophers, artists, because we also need non-technical people, so that because otherwise, we have to think on that moral, the moral questions here.
Absolutely. Well, thank you very much, Professor Peters. Thank you very much for being here today.
I thank you for the opportunity.